My soulmate may actually be carved.
The line must be wine.
Congratulations on Mamma Mia, Here We Go Again. It feels like such a fun-filled film. Is that part of the reason why you wanted to be involved with the project?
Well, I was told to be, but I'm certainly glad that I actually took my agent, my old agent, who was one of my dearest friends, became the head of Universal. And he called me and he said, "Cher, you're doing Mamma Mia," and he hung up.
There we go.
That's there one we way go to, again.
That's one way to book Cher. Andy, did you know that you'd have to perform a duet with Cher when you signed on to the movie?
Yeah. I think they said pretty much right away, they said, you know, you're doing this, and they hung up.
But it did work.
They knew it, and they told me the song, of course, because of the character. And I immediately went, you know, I said, okay, great. I felt it was a great opportunity. And I listened to the song, and I tried to figure out, okay, what song, you know, try to listen to the key of it. You know, you immediately start.
The work process.
The work process begins, you know, how do I compliment Cher? You know, how do I fit in there, you know, that complements what she's going to do.
And were you fans of Fernando before you filmed the movie? Was it one of your favorite ABBA songs? Or?
It's one of those songs that, you know, you hear it once and you can't, you know, it's like...
It's a great song.
It just stays with you, you know. All their hits that came to America are like that, you know. Mm-hmm. But for me, Fernando, for some reason, not because I played him, of all their songs that were in America as hits, that was the one that kind of I remember the most, you know, as growing up, you know.
Oh my God. I've decided to commit to being a grandmother.
Grandma, you weren't invited.
That's the best kind of party, little girl.
What do you think it is about ABBA's music that has such an enduring appeal, especially with the LGBTQ community?
I don't know. But I know that's true. You know, I know that's true, but I'm not exactly sure. But I think that it's the production and how good Benny is. And also, because they didn't write really in English, you know, I mean, that they were searching for things, they would turn things around. Like in Fernando, it was really hard for me to learn it in the beginning because it's not English, you know? So things are turned upside down, yeah. But that's what makes it really interesting when you get into the songs. Mm.
I don't pretend to be an expert to answer your question, but I think the songs have this respect respect for love and relationship in all forms and longing for that and the celebration of it. The songs are very celebratory in a way. You know, and there's also a sense of the emotional palette of the songs from longing and pain to love and respect and a sort of utopian love, the kind of love we all want, the kind of relationships we all want, I think can speak to all of us, you know, and I think people embrace that. I think that community has embraced it maybe for that reason too.